There are many science fiction movies that caught our imagination and, in some way, have shaped our thinking about dinosaurs. The problem is, much of what they taught us is wrong. The age of the dinosaurs is not this condensed period where every dinosaur was just wandering around the planet. Dinosaur communities were separated by both time and geography. On a timeline, the T-Rex is closer to humans than it is to a Stegosaurus. But did you know that the dinosaurs lived on the other side of the galaxy? Everything in our galaxy is spinning around the black hole at its center. The stars closer to the center spin faster, while those in the outer regions spin more slowly. Just as the Earth revolves around the Sun, our complete solar system revolves around the black hole at its center. We're moving at around 828,000 kilometers per hour, at approximately 28,000 light years from the galactic center. Based on our current position in the galaxy, we essentially complete an orbit every 250 million years or so.
The exoplanet systems we see on the sky are isotropically organized, they're random on the sky.
Dr. Jesse Christensen from the NASA Exoplanet Science Institute studies planet occurrence rates, or how often and what kinds of planets occur in the galaxy. She mapped out dinosaur evolution through the galaxy's rotation. She conveys that the astronomical timescales match up quite well with archaeological timescales. Last time our solar system was at its current point in the galaxy, dinosaurs were just emerging in a time known as the Mesozoic era. The Mesozoic era is divided into three periods, the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous period. During the Triassic period, all the continents were arranged together as a singular supercontinent called Pangea. The Jurassic period lasted for 55 million years, followed by the Cretaceous period, which lasted until the dinosaurs were extinct 65 million years ago, on an event known as the Cretaceous-Paleogene extinction event. The event, also known as the CKT extinction, is generally thought to have been caused by the impact of a massive comet or asteroid 10 to 15 kilometers wide. This is not the first such massive die-off in history, nor was it the largest. The Permian-Triassic extinction event, known as the Great Dying, occurred 251.4 million years ago and eradicated 96% of all marine species and 70% of all terrestrial vertebrate species on Earth. Dinosaurs such as Stegosaurus, Iguanodons, and Gigantosaurus lived through the early Cretaceous period while our planet was on the other side of the galaxy. 65 million years separate us from the famous T-Rex, whilst 83 million years separate T-Rex from Stegosaurus. The human brain isn't evolved to process big numbers, and we can't really visualize millions or billions. So let's use a different timescale to put things into more perspective. Let's assume that all of Earth time, from the very beginning of the dinosaurs to today, were compressed into 365 days, or one calendar year. Using this timescale, the dinosaurs appeared January the 1st, and became extinct by the third week of September. Using this timescale, the Earth would have been formed approximately 18.5 years earlier. Using the same scale, humans have been on Earth only since December 31st. Scientists think that birds are direct descendants of one line of carnivorous dinosaurs, and some consider that they in fact represent modern living dinosaurs. The theory remains under discussion and shows that there is still much we don't know about dinosaurs. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.